In this video, I'm going to show you how to add your existing email into Mac Mail app. So if you have your private email address, such as your name at example.com, or maybe your company email address, or your own email address, other than one of those free webmails. The free webmails is like a Gmail, Yahoo Mail, and Hotmail, and so on. But your private email address will be under your own domain than you made or company made it for you. Before you add, you need a couple of information. So what you need is email address and also password and some information from server. First, you need incoming mail server address. I'm going to show you an example of that. And also a port number for incoming mail server address, and outgoing mail server address, and a port number. Let me explain briefly what is this mail server address. Sounds like a foreign language. Basically, it's like a mailbox at your home. So you have mailbox, the outside of your home, it has in a box that if the USPS comes and drop the mail, then you pick it up, right? So that's something like an incoming mail server. Then if you want to send the email address, you use different box, basically. So that's different server. So it's a computer. Then usually you need two separate server for incoming, which is your receiving email, and outgoing, your sending email address. Sending email, so not address. So anyhow, so you need that information. You need to get it from your server. I'm going to show you how it looks like right now. So first, let's find out that information. So if you use private email address, in my case, I just use this service hosting, web hosting service. They are awesome, by the way. If you are hosting your website, you can host a website, but I use extensively for email address. Because for the plan, about top of my head, I don't remember, but it costs like 2 years, $100. So that's pretty cheap, right? It's like $5 a month or less. And you can have up to 100 email addresses per domain. That's pretty good. So anyway, so if you go to your email address setting information, this is something you might want to get. So incoming mail server, it said IMAP. It's IMAP. .hostinger.com and a port. So this type of information you need. And in my server, it says imap.hostinger.com. Then outgoing server, it said smtp.hostinger.com. And the port number is 465. And it might be different on your server, but usually the port is the same. So that's something you might want to find out. Then let's get started. What you're going to do is go to Mail app, and under Mail from the menu bar, click Add Account. Then you're going to have a couple options. Then choose Other Mail Account and hit Continue. And it's asking you to enter the name. This name field will be when you send the email, and the receiving end of it, so you're basically recipient, will see who is coming from. So whatever you decide to enter here will be show up on the other end. So I just put my name, I guess. All right. And email address, you want to enter the email address you want to add to this mail app, and password. Okay, enter the password now and sign in. Okay, so now since this is not the setup to automatically verify, you might get error message like this. Then it's completely normal. You don't have to freak out. And what you want to do is now it's going to open up a couple options, right? So for username, it said automatic. It might work, it might not. Most of the case, this username means email address. So what you want to do is simply copy your email address and paste it. That should do it, usually. But you might want to double check though with your server. Then incoming mail server, I'm going to copy my configuration. By the way, on my server, if you want to use IMAP connection or POP connection, it's different server address. Then, okay, let me quickly explain what's the difference between IMAP connection and the POP connection. By the way, I'm not sure if you're supposed to pronounce that way, but anyhow. So IMAP connection is, I think nowadays it's the most common connection. Because if you use your email address with multiple devices, that's the best way to do it. Because you can, basically your mail, it stays on the server. But you can access to your mail from smartphone and your computer or tablet or multiple device. So it's always in sync. That's the IMAP connection. But if you want to download emails into one device and you use only one device only, you might want to use POP connection or POP connection. Because whenever you refresh your connection, your computer or your device, whichever the device the connecting the mail server through POP connection, it's going to download everything into your device. You can set to leave email on the server, but the most common connection is you download everything into the computer. So the advantage is that is you can browse email without internet connection. Technically, you can do it in IMAP nowadays, but the POP connection is the best way when you access that particular email with only one device. It's because it's most simple. So most of the time nowadays, because we live in the world with multiple devices and with an email address, so I would say 80% of the time you might want to use IMAP connection. So I'm gonna do it that way. By the way, the switch is right over here, so you can switch. So I use IMAP connection, and I'm gonna enter. Basically, I'm gonna copy over here. And oops, it's missing I, so I enter. And outgoing server is over here. It's smtp.hosting.com. Usually it's the same, but this server is different. So again, you might want to double check. Then click sign in. Now it's connected. So for this email address, you have two services available. So mail and notes. So if you keep checking these notes, that means for your Mac Notes app, you can save notes under your email address. It's a little bit confusing. Then in general, I recommend not to use it. But if you want to do it, give a try. But in this case, I want to make everything simple. So just use for email only. So just keep mail checked and done. So as soon as you do that, it's going to add over here. Then start downloading email address. Right now, this email is empty, so you don't get anything. But what you want to do is from here, you might want to compose a new message. Make sure it's selected your email address and send it to someone, maybe your other email address, and then make sure it's received. And when you received on your another email address, you might want to reply and make sure you're received on your Mac as well. Okay, let's try that way. Okay, now let's test this out. So I'm going to send email from the email address I just added, which is 2. At, right? So let's compose this, and I'm gonna send it to my Gmail. And you can name it like a test, whatever you want. It's just this thing, okay? And hit this send button, and it's gonna send, sending, you know, this famous sending email address, I mean sound. And when I go to my Gmail, it's over here, I received it, right? So it's successfully sent. And now I'm gonna reply this to reply and send it. And coming back to your mail app. Pop up. So now I received it. So this confirms this email address is successfully added and communicating your server successfully. So good job done, right? And you might want to do, what you want to do next is create your email signatures. For that, I have a different video, so you might want to check it out if you are interested in it. So that's how you add your private email address into your app, mail app. Thank you for watching, and if you like this video, please give me a thumbs up, and if you like these contents, you might want to consider subscribe my channel so I can produce more contents like this. And until the next time, I'll see you later, and have a good day.